It is 8:17. You are watching BT Vancouver. Thanks for joining us on this Tuesday, September 1st. Well, today marks 40 years since the day Terry Fox was forced to stop running his Marathon of Hope. In honor of his legacy, the Terry Fox Foundation is releasing a book called Forever Terry. It features 40 letters from 40 Canadians about how Terry Fox inspired them. And joining us now is the one and only Fred Fox, Terry's older brother. Good morning. Always great to have you on the program.
Good morning. Great to be with you.
So this is the second book your family and the Terry Fox Foundation has produced in the last month. The first one was a children's book. It was called Terry and Me. And now today, Forever Terry is being released. Can you tell us more about this book?
Yeah, our family has been working with Penguin Publishing for several months now. And, we helped come up with about 40 people who, celebrities, people who have been inspired by Terry, Terry Foxers, people who have been part of the Terry Fox run for a number of years, and asking them to write a personal letter or reflection about Terry. And it's been a great experience connecting with people across Canada, as well as Canadians that are living abroad.
So the book features some letters that were written by some pretty big names now in Canada, Christine Sinclair, Wayne Gretzky. Which one surprised you the most, Fred?
I really enjoyed reading Wayne Gretzky's. Wayne actually visited Terry back in 1980 after Terry came back from the Marathon of Hope. He was in town to play against the Canucks and took the time to come and visit Terry. The stories that really inspire me are the ones that by Terry Foxers. Jim Therrien, who lives up in Prince George, has been fundraising for the last 30 plus years and is approaching very close to raising $1 million. Jocelyn Adams, who is in the Tecumseh-Hamilton area, a young student who's been fundraising. She's 16 now, Jocelyn is, but she's been raising money since she was in grade one. So it's those stories of Terry Foxers, the letters in the book from Terry Foxers, ordinary Canadians that really inspire me in the book.
Mm-hmm. And it's fascinating to see how he has connected with so many generations, from my parents who witnessed the Marathon of Hope 40 years ago to, my coworker's six-year-old daughter who is learning about him in school. So where can people find this book?
I believe it's in Indigo and Chapters. You can probably find it online as well. You go there and you can purchase the book. We're really looking forward to the people being able to engage with Terry and the various stories and remember what Terry what Terry started in 1980 on April 12th and the legacy that's continued after today, September 1st, with millions of people around the world continuing Terry's dream.
Mm-hmm. So the Terry Fox Run coming up on September 20th. I remember we had you on the program a few months ago to talk about the virtual run. It's still happening this year. It's going to look very different. Tell us about it and where people can sign up.
Yeah, go to terryfox.org to register, to create your own fundraising page. We've asked people, and our priority is to keep people safe and keep everyone healthy. And we're just asking people to do your Terry Fox run this year, on the one day your way. Start from your front step and go for a walk with your family or your close personal bubble or wherever you want. Go to the local park, but make sure you follow all the things that we need to do. Through this whole COVID pandemic that we've been going through the last 5 or 6 months, people are still being diagnosed with cancer, and raising money for cancer research is as important as it ever was. And so get out there, participate, register, and or donate to somebody that you know that's still participating.
All right. Fred, thank you so much for joining us this morning. Terry Fox Run, September 20th, and the book Forever Terry, now available. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right, day 22 now.